I got into music kind of haphazardly. I finished my degree at Glasgow, where I was doing French and comparative literature for 5 whole long years of my life. And I went travelling. And when I was in Budapest, I met this New Zealand DJ. And she, by the end of the week, persuaded me to listen to really crap demos on my phone of really old songs, and came up with the suggestion of a songwriting degree, which I had never even entered my head that anything like that existed. So I cut my travelling short by quite a few weeks and started applying to music schools. Got my audition at the Institute, and here I am in my second year doing what I want to do. I think this year's going to be a lot more fast-paced than my first year. My first year was completely finding my feet, finding my style. It's been an amazing kind of process doing that. I'm ideally releasing my first EP in the spring, and I think that's going to actually decide a lot of where my year's going to take me. I hope to have like some radio play, maybe do a mini tour of some sort, and be working on EP number 2, hopefully, the same year. I was a chalet host for a season in the Alps, so I had to cook dinner for 6 months for crazy families that would come and stay with me. And yeah, there was a few occasions where I like forgot to make the dessert and had to just like scramble nice spiced apples together, yeah. There were some crazy things that happened during that winter too, but I don't think they should ever go out into the world. I would say that I'm very ethical in my choices for, like, especially for food, recycling, plastic. That is important. And I'm very ambitious, especially since coming to London has really driven me. And Scottish, definitely Scottish. That was written in my first semester, in my first year here, as for one of the writing briefs. So it was politics that week, and in the media at the time was this whole case with Michael Brown being shot in Ferguson, Missouri. And you kind of couldn't get away from that as a news story, so I started really looking into it. And it's something that I think is a lot more present in the States, that kind of problem with, well, the fact they have guns, we don't have it here. So I started reading a lot of news articles and taking concepts and ideas from that and trying to put down what I could in that song to tell the story of what the reasons may have been for that happening and hopefully it not happening again. It is a really amazing artistic and creative output. So I get, every time I sit down to write, your mind changes, you have a different mindset, and you can just, it's so therapeutic. And I think that's why a lot of my songs are probably not that uplifting, because I think I'm quite like an upbeat person, it takes a lot to get me down, and I think it's because you have that other process where you just get it out of your system, and yeah, it's a therapy for me. I love melody, I love making things sound hopefully nice.